Let us leave the confusion and all this illusion.
I need my wine. What's the wine?
Just like birds of a feather.
Oh, no, I don't think wine.
There is wine somewhere. I need my glass. Happy Tuesday, peoples! How are you guys doing today? Welcome to another Tuesday with Make a Move Group in the kitchen. Hope you guys are having a fantastic Tuesday. It is hot down here in Florida, but you know what? We're gonna get some nice refreshing dishes right now.
Hey everyone, happy Tuesday! How are you guys doing? Thank you for tuning in.
All right, well, today we are doing our classic Italian dish. Can you say the name?
I have some stats, but I'll give you the stats while we're doing it. It's called the Caprese Sun. No, not the Caprese Sun.
Caprese Sun.
That's the juice.
Sun? I got you.
That's the juice. A Caprese sandwich. But we jazzed it up a little bit, so it's not, I mean, yeah. You'll see what we're going to do.
You got to always add your own little touch. We did a little bit, and also there's certain ingredients that if you don't have it, then you improvise. So let's start with that.
Substitutions.
Yes. So to start off, we're using Italian bread. Now you could use.
I'll give you
which breads.
The different ones is called the ciabatta, which is, by the way, 200 calories per bun. So that's why I didn't choose that one. Focaccia and artesian. All Italian breads, but what did we choose?
Italian bread.
Italian bread.
Standard
simple,
Italian
bread. Simple, right? You can find that
bread.
Anywhere.
You could go anywhere, Walmart, Aldi's.
Aldi's is where I go. That's kind of what I did. That's right.
All
right.
You also need some spinach, baby spinach.
Yeah.
You need some Parmesan cheese, the real one, not the one that is like powdered. Okay.
Oh, I didn't put my little.
You're gonna have a little bit of Italian seasoning and oregano.
That's
or you could do just basil.
That is the substitution of the basil that we don't have. Let's just talk about that.
Garlic minced, or the way I like it, I like to smash the garlic and then put it in. It's a lot more flavorful. But this works perfect. So if this is what you have, this is what you're gonna use. A little bit of mayo. And this is for the aioli, and we'll talk about that in a little bit. And a little bit of salt. And I think he has something in his mouth. Yes, he does.
Excuse me.
So he has something in his mouth, and she's taking care of the dog while I keep going here. You need a lemon or lime or whatever you want to call it. And tomato, fresh tomatoes. So to start off, we're going to do the garlic aioli.
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna take a tablespoon of mayo. You're gonna throw it in this beautiful. Oh my god, this looks amazing! Hold on. This is a finished product, but I'm just gonna show it to you real quick.
It's hot.
So, look at that. That's the garlic aioli. It's
hey,
perfect.
Carlos.
It's perfect. So to make the aioli, you're gonna go ahead. You're gonna take a tablespoon of mayo. You're gonna have a little bit of garlic in there. And you're gonna have the seasoning, the basil or Italian seasoning and oregano. You're gonna throw all that in there, a little bit of salt, and you're gonna squeeze some lemon in there. And you're gonna heat it up. It's gonna heat up, you're gonna mix it a little bit. And the Parmesan cheese. I don't know if I said Parmesan cheese, but you put the Parmesan cheese here also.
This is a rice cooker, actually. So this is really simple. I got this at Aldi's, I believe. That's right. So I want to show my little gadgets that I bought recently, which is really cool. This is where I make the
only $10.99,
something like that.
Or go to
Actually, it was Target. Target had this little pot, and the kid. It's easy for the kids to make rice, so they don't have to wait for me to make it anymore.
So it's pretty cool. So if you want to heat up a soup or whatever, it's perfect, and it has like little measurements and stuff inside. So there's the plug right there. Please send a check to us. Thank you very much. So we're gonna have this going on here, melting, and then you're gonna mix it. Make sure it doesn't burn, because if it burns, it's gonna be kind of like brownish and everything. It still tastes great, but
harder to spread.
Yeah, it's harder to spread. So
how do we cut the tomato?
You cut the tomato with a knife.
You don't chop suey it with the hand and just do that.
There was a guy like back in the 80s that he would just like smash the watermelons and stuff. Don't do that. So you're gonna cut it. This is the long tomatoes. You could use this ones or the big ones. Janice cut it on this ones, like on the sides, kind of like this. And then you cut that in three.
Welcome, Family Hub.
All right, we are in Family Hub as well. So follow us there. I don't know what that means, but just follow us. And then we're gonna go ahead and cut this here. This one is like pretty cool.
So yeah, it's the long way. So what we did also after he cut that,
it's gonna look like this.
This is one of the little, you know, actually the recipe calls for roasting cherry tomatoes on top of having sliced tomatoes, but why I have double tomatoes, I don't know, for me. We went ahead and just roasted it on the pan with a little bit of virgin olive oil, and then we added a little bit of Italian seasonings right over it, just so that when you're biting into the bread and the tomato, it's not a hard tomato that you're biting into, it's a nice, soft, seasoned one.
Yeah. There you go.
Which tastes better?
Which is pretty good. It makes it a little bit softer, so when you put it in the bread, it's just like, you'll try it and then you can tell me how you like it better. But yes, after we have this done, we'll dry the tomatoes, we'll do all this stuff real, and we'll set it aside. Now we're coming to the good part, which is assembling everything, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we're gonna take a piece of bread, I'm gonna put it here, very nice, and we need something to spread. So maybe we could
That's
spread
a good
this.
One. Here, we got this there.
Yeah, I don't think this is gonna work. So use a spoon.
Here. Oh, you might find one
right here. So you take the garlic aioli and you're just gonna spread it evenly throughout.
While he's doing that, let me give you some fun facts of this Capri. All right, let me turn this a little bit because D takes up a lot of the camera. So we're fighting for the camera here. All right, so where's the fun fact? All right, so first, the Capri was a salad, not a sandwich. And so the origins of it is the first Capri salad was made by an Italian stoneworker in the 1920s who created it after World War One, as a tribute to his country, Capri, which is a small island in Italy. The name translates to mean the salad of Capri. So that's that. And where did the Caprese, I hope I'm saying it right. Excuse me, all you Italians out there, if I'm like messing this up, but I'm trying my best. The Caprese sandwich, actually, where is that fact? Okay, here it is. In the 1950s, Farouk, who is an Egypt king, he wanted something more portable. And so he was given a salad in a bun. And that's how the Caprese sandwich came about. So there's a little bit
of
the
fun facts.
So
that was the Lunchables from back in the day.
That's it. So,
well, there you go.
This is a classic Italian dish, as you have heard.
There you go. Bam. Now, back to sexy man over here. Italian sexy man, Italian.
He is actually Italian. Who is Italian in your family, D?
From my dad's side.
Okay.
All right, so we're gonna have...
Gretchen!
Now, mind you, this mozzarella, it's supposed to be the...
I couldn't find the round, nice, fresh cut slice.
This will suffice, so you're gonna put them here. After you put the aioli, you're gonna do this.
Get two in there. I sliced... D, you love cheese.
But the thing is that I want to have this, and then after it's done, put another cheese on top, and then put in a broiler and just broil it on top, and that is banging.
We're gonna get the cheese going here. Who else is there?
Claje de queso.
Carlos, I have some for later.
There we go. All right. Bam. Okay, so you got two cheeses here.
This is going to the Zoom world right away.
So it's gonna be like that. Doo-doo-doo-doo. And then we're gonna bring out the other one, just like you see on the TV, HGTV, or however you wanna call it.
Let's move these tomatoes over.
Oh, the tomatoes are going in there and then being roasted, and then here you go, they're done. Not even a microwave can do that. What? All right, so now that we have it here all done, what do we do?
You add some of the baby spinach and arugula. There is just spinach, and there is also just arugula, but I found the mix in Aldi's, which is my favorite store. So that's what we're gonna add.
So we add kind of like a dab.
Yeah.
You just like.
That's it.
Throw that in there. Look at that. This looks good. All right, so now we have it all done, and now we put this on.
That's right.
So
two tomatoes on each.
Two tomatoes.
Now you can assemble it all and then just stick the whole entire thing in the toaster, and that way everything kind of heats up together. You can do it now as well for a little bit longer. Maybe even adding like D-Light, you know, adding a little bit more of the cheese on top and then putting it right back in to just kind of.
So this is pretty much it.
Heat it a bit.
Right?
That's it.
And then you heat it up a little bit. Now on my take, I will put more cheese, like sprinkled on top. So you gotta sprinkle more cheese. Then take the torch it a little bit.
That's right.
And that's it. Ready to eat.
Now here's how you're gonna assemble this for your guest. Right, so we're gonna clear this spot. We have a gathering on Friday, which I'm really excited about, and I'm actually gonna do this. So those that are coming on Friday, if you're watching this and you don't come, you're missing out.
And if you haven't been invited, then
sorry, next time. All right, so you take this, right? You go ahead and you cut it in half. And just like Dee, you called it, what is this? Like little tapas?
Yeah.
Put it there.
It's kind of like a bruschetta.
Like a bruschetta, yeah. So, the cheese got out. So you go ahead and cut it. Actually, you can make little mini sandwiches. If you want to take both of these halves and put them like this.
That's kind of like how this was invented, because somebody wanted it to go.
To be a sandwich. All right.
So they put it all in a bun.
You can also drizzle some virgin olive oil over this. And then add a little bit like that. That's really nice. And that's it. This is your hors d'oeuvres or your dinner or your lunch, which is each bread slice is 170 calories. The rest is a little bit of cheese, garlic.
Who's counting?
I have to, but there you go. We hope you like it. Italian night. Dee, close it up.
All right. Well, you already know what's the deal. That's what we're gonna have in a little bit.
Follow us. And it's refreshing.
Follow us on all social medias. You already know all the platforms, Facebook, Instagram, and all that good stuff. And she's trying it, so let's see what the reaction is.
I like the garlic with the mayonnaise and the lime. And it just all comes together. It's really refreshing. It really is. I like it. My taste buds are happy.
All right, let's see how this goes.
Try it.
Let me try this thing.
There's more people on Instagram, Facebook, I don't know what it is, but you like it? It's approved.
I just need wine.
Oh, you know what you can add? What's a good ham that you can put along with this? That bruschetta ham? Prosciutto. There you go. If you wanted to add some protein in it, you can do that as well. But it's good. All right, that's it. We'll continue to eat off camera. Thank you so much for tuning in. Janice and D'Angelo with the Make a Move group at Keller Williams. We love to do these every Tuesday. We have recipes lined up for like the next 6 weeks that are fun, refreshing, light. And most importantly, why we do this is to show you guys how quick and easy you can do different things in the kitchen that don't take you a lot of time to make for your family.
Correct. And when you make this and you have people over, you look like a freaking rock star. Look at this. Hey, listen, I made something real quick. I just threw
it's fancy. There.
Boom. There you go.
With wine.
I'm still waiting for my glass, but I guess it's not coming.
Oh.
Anyways, thank you for tuning in. We'll see you next Tuesday. Peace out. See you later.
Bye. See ya.
Okay.
Coño, okay, there you go.